worlds collide, something inside me is gone. Still I keep going on.
What is up, guys? 3D's Awesome here. Welcome back to another episode of Road to Rosie Boa. It's day 3. Hope you guys are excited. I'm excited. I think we're going to the pet store today. Look, we came into the mail today. This is the reptilian heat pad under tank heater. So they do make specialized heating pads for heat pad setups. So I'm really excited about that. And this will plug in to this thing here. And this will monitor its temperature and make sure it doesn't overheat. That's ideal. A lot of reptile owners really like that, and I'm excited to use it. We're not gonna set it up just yet until we're closer to the actual day that we will get her. But I wanna show you guys something I posted on Facebook. So here is an awesome Facebook group that I am in. I'm in a couple Rosie Boa Facebook groups, but this is Facebook group Rosie Boa Morphs and Localities. Get this cool picture right here, and I made it asking for names. Now I have this beautiful girl coming home and struggling with the names. So we got Daisy, we got Sunshine, we got Nancy, we got Cream Pop, Sherbert, and then Mingo. And so far, when I checked it earlier today, Nancy, well, I mean, still in the lead, but with 29%, but now 27. So Daisy and Sunshine are neck and neck, and then Nancy is in the lead. Mingo, and I mean the winner of this poll may not dictate what I name her. I also have to, you know, hold her and handle her and, you know, get a sense of her personality. And so far, but I do like all these names. I mean, Cream Pop, it's okay. Nancy, I think that's an okay name as well. I really like these two, and I really like Mingo. And if you didn't know what she looks like, I'll show you a picture on screen now. I would scroll down to the picture, but there's other people's, you know, names. And I don't want to, you know, do that. So that's really fun. So if you guys have a name suggestion, you know, comment it down below into the comment section. And, you know, we'll see as time goes on. But these are names that kind of been floating around rent-free in my head. And I do like them all. Another great thing about this Facebook page, and, you know, I'm just sticking out to block names, and, you know, just so you can't see names, I don't want to upset anybody that in this group that may watch this, so I'm just trying to be really careful with that. Ooh. Oh yeah, it's starting to rain. But another great thing about this Facebook group in particular is that they have, the admins have awesome care sheets, like as PDFs that you can, if you have a printer, you can print them out, and this is what I'm reading here. And it really, like, it's really good care sheet. Has a lot of accurate information that I hear a lot from, you know, Rosie Boa breeders and keepers that I hear a lot from. So it's all here. I got to regurgitation. And, you know, if a snake were to regurgitate, people say you can wait 7 days, but most owners will say 14 days. And that's what it says here. So that's awesome. So if you got a Rosie Boa and you're kind of not sure how to take care of it, or you're feeling like the information, you're getting a lot of different types of tips and information from different breeders, I think this one's really good. Because I have books over there that I feel like have some misleading information, or the information is not digestible as this one is. So that's another key thing. So you got a Rosie Boa or you're getting one, I would join this Facebook group. I will link in the description down below. And you can, it is a private group, so you're gonna have to fill out some stuff. And yeah, so that's really about it, guys, for talking about this group. I was also watching this awesome tarantula channel. You know, he's feeding his tarantulas.
Remember exactly what it was? Because so sick. I actually, you know.
Alrighty, everyone. So this is gonna wrap up episode 3. Didn't go to the pet store again, but that's fine. That's perfectly fine. I did want to update you guys and end this off with, I did get some hides. I did get one of these. I think I got this one right. Wow, this mouse wheel is really sensitive. I did get this medium high box. I got the Crocodile Skull, and I think I got the Primal Skull. So that should be coming. And then I went on Amazon and I got another hide from Zilla Products, which is very fitting for the channel. And no should be on the way for it's the end of the day. So I'm wrapping up and ready to go to bed. But those should be relatively coming soon, and we'll unbox those on one of the Road to Rosie Boa days if they ship in time. Also, some other fun stuff along the way. And you know, a lot of you might be thinking like, wow, this has become really expensive. You spent a lot of money on this. Keep in mind, guys, I did downsize. And a lot of the money has gone to the reptile, the Rosie Boa. Close the door. Thank you. So I wouldn't, as I haven't really spent a paycheck on this, the Rosie Boa just yet. I think I did do a part with the paycheck. I think I bought the snake with the actual like tips that I've made, and you know, some, you know, and some of my paycheck that I actually got for last week, and maybe some substrate, but everything else from aquariums, tongs, books, cleaning care, and you know, hides have come from selling most of my collection, and still kind of doing so. You know, just kind of hold, you know, grabbing something and holding it and being like, do I really have, does this have value to me? Do I have like, can I not live without it? And that's usually how I get rid of it. That's usually how I decide what I keep. This, for some reason, I can't live without this. And a lot of my figures. These, I can't either. So, I'm trying to get rid of those sodas. There's a couch downstairs too. So, you know what? It is expensive, but technically, everything that goes, you know, all this stuff that goes out, it's actually coming back in. So, that's really fun. Also, guys, another tip is, do you payment methods, man? I mean,
you got a credit card, you know, use your credit card, pay, do monthly payments, or what
you can do is use what I do at checkout with PayPal, do 4 payment option. So basically you do a payment of whatever amount every 2 weeks. That's what I've been doing on a lot of this stuff. So, like, instead of, like, oh, $250 for an enclosure, well, split that up to almost, like, $60 over 2 weeks. And while you still are spending the exact amount, you're paying it over time. And it makes life more easier. So, that is my tip for that, guys. That will wrap up day 3. I'm going to go to bed and actually edit this so that you're seeing it right now. But I'm ending it the day before you see it, right now. Obviously, still got some stuff to do. I mean, I'm not going to be able to do everything, but overall, preparing for the snake has improved my day-to-day life, and that makes me really happy. And I hope you guys are enjoying the content. You got about almost like 2 weeks worth of these daily videos, which is really cool. But this one, the first 3 so far have not been exciting, but hopefully we can try and make it a little exciting. But anyways, guys, I'm going to wrap it up here. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. And as always, stay awesome.
In my mind, worlds collide, and something inside me is gone. Still I keep holding on. In my mind, oceans divide and I don't know where I belong. But still I keep going.